Hello everyone, in this session we are going to see about instruction scheduling. Instruction scheduling is nothing but scheduling the execution of the instruction. Instruction has to take less number of cycles to complete the execution so that the performance of the processor will be increased. The time taken to execute instruction depends on the implementation of pipeline. So here the pipeline plays a major role for the instruction scheduling. Here we will see a few of the instruction and how many cycles they are taking to complete the execution. If the instructions are addition, subtraction and logical operation, they all take only single cycle to complete. And shifting instruction also, for few shifting instruction, in immediate value will be there to indicate the number of bits to be shifted. For those kind of instruction, these kind of instruction are taking single cycle to complete the execution. But in few shifting instruction, register will be there which holds the number of bits to be shifted. So those kind of instructions are taking one more cycle to complete. And if the instructions writing the new address to the PC, then those instructions are taking additionally two more cycles. Next, load instruction. Load instructions which loads the n32-bit words of memory such as LDR, load register, load multiple register, they are taking n cycles. For example, LDM register, load multiple register are loading 4 32-bit register. So that instruction will take 4 cycles to complete. Next, load instruction that loads 16-bit or 8-bit data such as LDRB, LDRSB, LDRH, LDRSH, they all take single cycle. Next, branch instruction. Branch instructions are taking 3 cycles to complete. Next, store instructions also. It is same like load instruction only. To store n number of register, it takes n cycles. Next, we'll see. To understand how the scheduling is implemented in ARM, we need to understand how the pipeline is implemented in that particular ARM processor. For example, here we will consider ARM9. In ARM9, there are 5 stages in pipeline: fetch, decode, ALU, LS1, LS2. In fetch, the insertion will be fetched from the memory and the address of that insertion will be loaded to the program counter. Next, decode. In decode stage, the input of operands will be decoded by the processor. Next, ALU. In this stage, the insertion is executed. LS1, LS2. In LS1, load store data specified by loader store instruction. If the instruction is not a load store instruction, then this LS1 stage will not have any effect. Next, LS2, if the instruction is LDR for 8-bit, for loading or storing 8-bit or 16-bit data, then this fifth stage will be there for that instruction. If that instruction is not loading 8-bit or 16-bit data, then there is no fifth stage for that instruction. And another thing, in ARM, in the program, ARM program, few instruction needs the result of previous instruction. But in such a case, those previous results are not ready, then processor will stop executing the next instruction. This task is called pipeline hazard or pipeline interlock. So whenever the instruction requires the result of previous result which is not available or which is not ready yet, then the processor starts. This process is known as pipeline hazard or pipeline interlock. We'll see few examples. First example, there are two instruction. To complete these two instruction, processor takes only 2 cycles. Here there is no interlock, because in the first cycle, add instruction will be completed. Add instruction will add R0 and R1 and stores the result in R0. In the first cycle itself, this R0 will be ready. Then in the second cycle, next add instruction will be executed. Since the R0 was ready by the first cycle, here in the second cycle, this add instruction will use that R0 and it will complete the execution. So these two instruction takes only 2 cycles. Next example, here we have interlock. It's because this LDR instruction. This LDR is loading 32-bit register, so it has to reach the fourth stage, LS1 stage. Here the instruction, there are only 2 instruction, but It needs three cycles to complete these two instruction, because in the first cycle LDR in the first cycle LDR will be fetched and it will be moved to decode stage. So by the time ADD will be fetched, then LDR will move to ALU stage. In ALU, in the first cycle, ALU finds the memory address, because LDR means loading this R1 from this memory. So first we need memory. So memory is found by adding R2 and 4. So ALU is finding memory address by adding R2 and 4 in the first cycle. See this add insertion. This add insertion needs R1 value. This LDR insertion will be completed when it reaches LS1. So by the time when it reaches when the LDR reaches LS1, already this add insertion will have reached ALU. But in this stage, it will not be completed. Why? Because it needs R1 value, which is not yet ready. So it has to wait for one cycle. So only this instruction is taking two cycles. So when the R1 is ready, then add instruction will be executed. So between this one cycle, this add instruction will be stalled. This is called interlock. So these two instructions are taking together three cycles. Next example is for branch instruction. There are five instruction. Out of these five, only three instruction will be executed, because the first instruction, move instruction, will be executed. Next we have branch. For branch instruction, program will jump to this case one. In case one, we have sub instruction. This will be executed. So the executed instructions are move, and next to this one, next to this one. So these instruction will be executed. To execute these three instruction, this processor is taking five cycles. We'll see how in the first cycle move instruction will be executed. Then in the second cycle, branch instruction, the target address of branch instruction will be found by ALU. In the second cycle, target address of the case 1 address will be found by ALU. Then this new target address will be loaded to program counter, because the program counter will be having the next address. For the branch instruction, program counter will get the target address. So loading the target address to the PC, it is called a refilling PC. This refilling process takes two cycles. So to complete only this branch instruction, we need three cycles. Then program counter got new address, it will directly jump here. Then this insertion will be executed. To execute this, we need one single cycle. So to execute 1, 2, 3, these three instruction, we need 1, 3. One, totally five instruction to complete the execution. So I repeat, branch instruction takes three cycles. In the first cycle, ALU finds the target address. Then this target address will be loaded to program counter. This process is called the refilling. This refilling takes two cycles. So to complete the branch instruction, we need three cycles. Thank you.